Yeah, hi guys. Today we are going to discuss about parsing and error recovery. There are two types of parsers we know all about. One is top-down parser, another one is bottom-up parser. LL parser is the category, the famous LL parser is a category towards top-down parser. All the shift-reduced parser are comes under bottom-up parser. These are all the parsing techniques so far now we have seen. Now we are going to move on to the error recovery mechanism. There are two things again, error deduction, error recovery. First, it has to deduct the error. Subsequently, only we can think of error recovery mechanisms. Not for all the error, certain level error can be recovered automatically. If you look at the modern IDEs like PyCharm, like Google Colaboratory, if you are doing your coding, automatically it will deduct and it won't go for recovery. It will inform you this is where the mistake gone. So that error deduction and the report itself has some error recovery mechanism. Till Python language or whatever the language we are having in our curriculum, none of the compiler has error recovery mechanism, but it deducts well and it starts giving the better report or the highest form of understanding way it starts communicating. That is the best part I can explain. When you look at C programming, the error report itself, error reporting mechanism itself, it is, I can say it is a little weaker because it is not giving the human readable format or understandable format. When it comes to Python, it gives detailed report, almost the dependency errors. There would be error at line number.
The slide is not visible.
Not visible? Error recovery, parsing and error recovery mechanism, not even, someone said no, it is visible now. And what is
again,
happening?
No, it's not visible, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. I'll share it. No, nothing to worry. So anyway, now is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that's it. So error recovery mechanism, when we go to the modern IDEs, what is happening? It starts giving all the dependency errors also. What is a dependency error stands for? If any user have committed error on line number one, so how that affects all the consecutive statements. So that dependency notification, it is much detailed report than C language. That much only I can say. Recent day, the couple of languages, even Java gives much better or detailed report than C language. Reporting mechanism only I'm trying to tell. I'm not comparing the power of the language and all. The reporting mechanism is bit weak when we compare to C language. Java language, if you look at the explanation of the error report, is much more better. If we compare Python language, it is still better, I can say. The error reporting mechanism is still better. So this is the indication I want to give. Now parsing and error recovery. Now is it visible, ma? Error recovery, there are points, pink color and blue color slide is given. What is error recovery mechanism? How it behaves? Any one of you please acknowledge. Because the first time I'm using slide. Earlier I used to give Word document. So broad slide. So it is creating trouble for me. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay, ma'am. Thank you. Now let us move on. What should happen when your parser finds an error? The moment the parser finds error, what are all the internal steps going on within the compiler? It will stop immediately and signal an error. This is one step. The moment it detects, it will stop the compilation process and it will immediately report the error, or signal an error means reporting the error. Record the error but try to continue. This is also possible. It will start noting down the error and it will continue the parsing action, or it continue the compilation action, or it continue with the translation action. What is a translation? The entire role of compiler itself is converting high level language to low level language in different stages. So when it starts converting from one form to another form, that process will continue. Although error is detected, excluding those portions, it will continue with the rest of other portions. the translation activity will continue. So this is the way it works. These are all the two things can happen. In the first case, user must recompile from the scratch.
You are in still first slide only, ma'am.
How come here I am seeing second slide? See, parsing and error. Second thing, I am having this error. The second slide I moved on, ma. With that only I am.
No.
Not it?
Here, no. We didn't get that one now.
Okay. One thing I'll do. Now is it visible? Error recovered.
Yes, ma'am.
Blue yes, color, ma'am. Pink color. Yeah, okay, ma'am. So otherwise, now next class onwards, never I use PPT because it is creating trouble for me. I don't know about others. So when it becomes stop immediately and signal the error, or record the error and continue the compilation process. So this is execution I'm not talking. Only the compilation process I'm talking about. Execution, it is not possible until complete error or free from the error. So next case is, if it is early stoppage, then we must recompile and scratch from after possibly a trivial fix. What is trivial fix? Is a possible trivial solution you would have heard in your finite automata. So possibility of computer to go with the execution, you need to fix the way how the compiler can proceed further. What is the meaning is, your output may be wrong, that is a different story, that is related to semantic, but the compiler should be in the position to read and to proceed further. In that circumstances, how much user is putting effort in correcting the error, after that only it will move further. Second case, user might be overwhelmed. They will be overwhelmed by a whole series of error message, all caused by essentially the same problem. So these are all the two things. Either it will proceed and it will give all the error report together, and it will early stop and it will give you the error and a trivial fix. Now I ask you the question. C language comes into which category? It will stop the error. It will stop the compilation as soon as it it detects the error, or it proceeds the compilation till the end. Tell me the answer. Which method it is using? The error number 1 at line number 4, it detects, for example, in C language. Will it stop the compilation, or it will record that error, it will proceed further? Please tell me. Which way it works? C language. Two method, no? Slide you could able to see, no? I have put two methods. So among those two methods, which method C is working? C compiler is functioning. Come on, yaar. It's a very simple question. You know C language. If you say I don't know C, that's all. Which method or which way C compiler is functioning? Working. Am I audible? Come on, guys. The moment it sees the error, will it stop the compilation, or it will record or report about all the error at the end of the compilation? Tell me. Use either chat window or audio note. First one. C6 is telling first one, na? Yeah. Let us continue further. It won't stop immediately. C compiler continues to the end of your program, recording all the error. But if you commit error in the line number 6, but line number 10 is dependent on the line number 6, then it will be notifying line number 10 also. Whether it is standalone error or dependency error. What is dependency error is one error in a line that will affect some other line in the program. What is independent error? No way that is related with the earlier error, but it will have error. So you can able to connect the way we write the program. That's all. So these are all the two methods available. Now is it visible? Error recovery mechanism. Now only we are getting into the subject matter. Error recovery mechanisms I have put in this slide. So what are all the error recovery mechanisms? How we can do? How not we, the compiler or the compiler developer, language designers, language constructs, how they can do? They can adjust the input stream so that parser can continue after unexpected input. One adjustment. What is the input? Input means what? Role number one may be writing the program, submitting to the C compiler. Role number two may be writing the program, submitting to the C compiler. That all of your C program is example for input stream. So what is the way error recovery mechanism works? It will start adjusting the input stream to the compiler. The user written program itself corrected. That is called error recovery mechanism. What are all the possible adjustments? There are few syntaxes, Python, when you start writing, it will automatically get corrected. Few things are doing automatically. Deleting the token is possible. What is token C? The first unit we discussed, every component of your program which you have written is termed as token. So either you can delete the token, or you can insert the token, or you can substitute the token. These are all the three methods available for error recovery with respect to input stream adjustment. What is input stream? Compiler, we need to give input. All of our user programs, once the compiler is released for the public, the moment every one of us tend to write a program or project, whatever. So what we give it to the compiler is termed as input stream. So with that, compiler tries to do delete token, insert token, substitute token. Then there are two classes of recovery mechanism: local recovery, global recovery. These are all the two popular recovery mechanisms applicable for both bottom-up parser and top-down parser. This is common for both. How it functions, let us see. Adjust input at the point where error was detected soon after the compilation, after the deduction. That means the compiler will take users, roll number one's program, let us say for example. Roll number one submits a program to the compiler. At the line number 10, he or she committed a mistake. It will start deducting that error. After deduction, it will start going for recovery. That is called local recovery. Next, we are moving on to global recovery. What it does is, it will start predicting that erratic situation, error committed by the user, before even start the compilation. That is global recovery mechanism. So error recovery is possible both in top down and bottom up parser, as I mentioned earlier. Now, at the whole or complete error types in the compiler, one is compile time error, second one is runtime error. Lexical phase error, syntactic phase error, semantic phase error, phase wise error will be detected. Let us see what are all these errors. Then we will go back to global recovery, error, local recovery, panic mode recovery, the other recovery strategies, let us see. This is in broader perspective I am telling or listing out the possible error we can face with the programming languages or compile time error, runtime error. Lexical error. What is a lexical error? It's a sequence of characters that does not match the pattern of any token. What is that? Tokenization. 0 to 9 to the power of plus. This is a regular expression. This regular expression is for number, whole number or integer number representation. This is a regular expression for letters token. Not I'm telling identifier, just letters token. If anything you tend to give for this based on this grammar alone, anything else is treated as error. So completely regular expression is taking care of detecting the lexical error. Within the compiler design, if the developer does not gives the particular input based on the given regular expressions, definitely it will be notified as an error. For any language, definitely the compiler developer will come out with lot of regular expressions. minimum it will have 30 to 50 expressions. Minimum I am telling. Python language you can't even imagine, it will be more powerful. When it becomes C, the regular expressions are minimal. All the keywords on regular expression, all the types of number representation, that is integer number representation, float number representation, double number representation, number representation would become one of the regular expression. Then identifier, variable representation, all the identifier. What are all identifier? Variable name, constant name, function name. These are all few example for identifiers. So for these all one regular expression. Then for the operators, regular expression, separate regular expression or finite automaton, either way you can interpret. For arithmetic operators, then relational operator, then logical operator, bitwise operator, etc. So it will have some set of 5 to 10 regular expressions within C language. When the power of the language computation is becoming more, then number of regular expressions would be more. The primary purpose of regular expression is to detect lexical errors. Only it will detect. Then error recovery mechanism would become different. Then error recovery mechanism can be of the form local error recovery, global error recovery, or you can think a common human language perspective, deletion of some token, insertion of some token, and updation of some token. This is another category. There is yet another category, rewriting the production. We can write the best productions, or that production will detect the error through that appropriate detection using the grammar. Then we can go for error recovery mechanism. So these are all the three major strategies we can think of. Now look at this LR parser error. Now we are in the slide LR parser error. Hope so you could able to see what is the slide title, LR parser error. We started with lexical error. Now I am on the slide LR parser error. Look at this. Normally this E1, E3, E2, E4, they used to write in the table empty with an empty values. How the error recovery can be done or error reporting can be done is, for every recovery or error entry, we need to give a number, error number, error 1, error 2, error 3, error 4, error 5, instead of emptiness. Emptiness, if we try to give, it may get into infinite loop, error 6, error 7. Like that, we need to give the number, then every error will be notified with the appropriate indications. E1, missing operand, when this E1 will come, whenever missing parenthesis or missing operand, end of notice missing, E1 will come. I'm just giving example, this is not perfect, just for academic point of view, that errors are should be written with the error report. Every error should not be left as such undefined. Never we should leave it as empty. Empty is a danger. This is a non-deterministic situation, or it will get into infinite loop. Then any corruption also may happen. Execution corruption also may happen. Everything we need to be deterministically represented. No fuzzy situation. So when those error entries, empty cells are notified or have seen, that needs to be interpreted with the error report. That error report, if it is defined well, if we able to detect a part of the error or the context of the error, then we can make the compiler to go to the next step, error recovery mechanism. For that, this is a preliminary step. So this is how LR parser error detection is happening. Now let us look into the next step. This is semantic error. I started with what is lexical error, what is syntactic error, what is semantic error. Semantic error, we have not yet started. Fourth unit only, we will look at what is semantic action, semantic. First you should understand, then you can understand. However, it is possible to interpret. Look at the first example, int a of 10, comma b. This is mistake, small a. It should become small a. Anything we type in the PowerPoint, no, it becomes capitalized word and PowerPoint. Small a equal to b. What is the error it will give notification is, syntactically it is correct. Context free grammar or the production CFG will start giving us, it is a right, A equal to B it will tell. But what is the other situation? Int A of 10 comma B, always name of the array indicates the address of an array, base address of an array. This is name of the array. No index values are passed. Whenever we are representing name of the array alone, it signifies the address of the base address of an array. But we are trying to give a normal integer value to become address. During, after compilation or during execution only, this will be notified. Earlier, it is very tough to predict. So this kind of error are example for semantic error. How we can rewrite A of 1 or A of 2 with this index, array index value, if user 10 to writes, no error. Or else what we should do? Try to assign address of A to B to A. You need to declare this B as an pointer. Then this one should become pointer. Only then it can, it is capable of receiving address of B to A. Either way need to be corrected. Right now it is not appropriate for the semantic action. That is the final conclusion. This is called semantic error. Let us look at another example. If k is equal to 1, we are initializing k is equal to 1 in the if statement. It is appropriately right only because if of something sufficient, if of k is assigned with 1, then if of k, then it becomes true. Then the control enters into this body of the execution. Then immediately it does the statement called return 1. What it does is completely in the main, only one main, the first return is suitable for the main statement. Then your program will be terminated. It will not execute print k function. If you are expecting the k value to be printed, it is not at all possible. Because we are using the return statement, any moment in a C program, it deducts the first return statement unnecessarily without the function representation, the entire program itself will get terminated. So the very first return statement will get associated with main function. So you cannot expect the output of print. These are all few examples I'm trying to make you to understand related to semantic error. There are several more semantic error we can talk about it. Now let us come on to the topic of discussion. Error recovery strategies within the parser. There are four famous or popular error recovery strategies. Panic mode recovery, phrase level recovery, error production. We need to introduce rewriting the production, I said. We need to introduce error production so that the production will capture the error and we can think of recovering that production error. Then global correction. These are all the four possible error recovery mechanism. Let us see what is panic mode recovery. What this panic mode recovery says is it will try to discard the input symbol until the right token is found. I have the subsequent slide example also for this. Nothing to worry right now. You try to capture how much is possible. For example, you may write int A, B, comma B, then comma C, semicolon. This is how you need to write. Instead, what you are doing, int A, because I'm not able to write here. There is no pen accepted by Microsoft Word. So this, what is this is, whenever this token you are trying to give int A, int space A, you are not giving space. Let us imagine you are combining int A, space B, comma C and semicolon. Then what it does is it will start discarding the input up to int is right. The next one letter only making that to become wrong, that A. So it needs to discard. Discard means it just ignore. The moment it starts ignoring A, the entire statement will become right. So this is called panic mode recovery. So this one, very simple recovery strategy, corrects single error. It is not powerful for correcting multiple error. May leads to additional error as well. For example, instead of int space A, user tries to write int A and space BC. Subsequently, user tries to write A variable in many circumstances. That is not possible for the parser to detect and recover. It cannot interrelate. Okay, then advantage of panic mode recovery is simplicity. Never it will get into infinite loop. That is the only assurity. These two slides are same only. This started focusing on types of error recovery mechanism. Started with the panic mode recovery. Again, we are moving to panic mode recovery only. Only the advantage point of view I'm telling. Here drawbacks. It corrects only the single error, not the multiple error. That may lead to additional error. This is the message I want to convey. After drawback, in this slide, I want to convey the advantages of panic mode error recovery. Simplicity and no infinite loop. These are all the two benefits. Now let us move on to the phrase level error recovery. What it tries to does is local correction. It will start replacing the incorrect character by a correct one. Character by character, it will start go. For example, replace comma by semicolon. Replace open bracket, square bracket by the parenthesis. See, your thought would be telling to type only the open bracket. By mistake, you may choose that square bracket also. So it will try inserting, deleting the semicolon, replacing parenthesis by open bracket, square bracket, or replacing open square bracket by parenthesis, vice versa. And then replacing comma by semicolon. Used in error repairing compilers. This is the kind it is useful in the error recovery strategy or repairing the compilers. Drawback. Difficulty in assessing the actual error. Where exactly error has come. Understanding would be the difficult part. Then drawback is this may lead to infinite loop. This error recovery mechanism will lead to infinite loop. Next, error production. What is it? Expecting what are all the way user will commit an error and implementing grammar rules, CFG rules accordingly. We need to anticipate. Anticipate means we need to predict, forecast. What are all the possible way user can commit error? Tend to write wrong statements. Then accordingly, we need to anticipate the error and implement the grammar. We need to construct the parser to detect all the anticipated error. In future, user may tend to write erratically. And assuming that, we need to harvest all the types of error. After collecting all the types of errors, we need to construct the parse tree. Instead of parse tree, I can say CFG also. The parser then implements the appropriate error diagnostic. These are all the steps. Your compiler has this strategy. Yet another compiler. Yawk is one of the inbuilt tool. Most of the compiler developer, they will dependent on several tools for each and every phase of the compiler. They don't sit and write from the scratch. They will try to understand the existing tools for every phase of the compiler. They will bring or plug in those tools. Beyond that, what is required for that particular language, they may be implementing. If you look at Yawk, this is popular. In your senior syllabus, this was kept in our college. Yawk, yet another compiler. This is a famous tool. Similarly, Lex. Lex is a famous tool for lexical analysis. When you are trying to do lexical analysis for the particular context, you need to write n number of lines in C program. Whereas if you use Lex tool, within 4-5 lines, it is possible to rewrite that program using Lex. Similarly, if you are trying to implement parsers, any parser, LL parser, LR parser, any type of parsing action or context-free grammar representation using C program, it will become very tedious for the user to develop. In equivalent to that, syntactic analysis tool is Yawk. Similarly, you discussed around several or 6 to 7 phases of compiler. Every phase we can find out equivalent ready-made tools available. Few are open source, few are licensed, but tools are available already. So recent time, whenever people are getting into NLP, natural language programming or processing, they are highly dependent on linguistic compiler design, linguistic computation. By the time, again, these all the concept people need to learn, the basics of CFG, regular expression, recovery mechanisms, deduction and parsing action, types of parser, these all everyone we need to learn the moment you, if you become NLP practitioners. So this is the tool YAC is meant for syntactic analyzer or context free grammar. The next one is global correction. Yeah, almost it become 11:50. Maybe another 10 more slides I may be having. Let us move on to the next session, because I don't want to